Hi students, welcome to SFS Kambam online classes. This is your Vijay Kumar sir, teaching social studies 8th class. My dear children, all of you follow our YouTube channel. Channel name is Vijay sir YouTube channel. Just subscribe and like so that you can get notifications of our lessons every day. So kindly follow our lessons so that it is very helpful for you to write the examinations and also get the good marks. Okay, without wasting our time, let's get started. Thank you. Hi students, welcome to SFS Kambam online classes. This is your Vijay Kumar sir, teaching social studies 8th class. My dear children, today we are going to discuss the last concept in third lesson, that is temperature belts on the earth. You know the meaning of belt. Belt means repeating the same activity. Okay. So here already we have seen many things in the last classes and we discussed many things about this earth and tilt position, right? Let us see how the effect of the tilt of the axis combines with the spherical shape of the earth to influence the distribution of solar heat over the earth. How this spherical shape and tilt position of the earth are going to influence the distribution of solar heat on the surface of the earth. We saw earlier in the classes that when the solar rays strike the earth's surface, they fall straightly in some portions which face the sun directly and fall slanting or making an angle as you move away from the portion. That means if you observe, the sun rays falls on the equator straightly. Okay, the rays are falling on the equatorial region straightly. That means the earth is going to receive more temperature, more hotter in this region. If you go away from this equatorial region, that means if you move towards the north pole or south pole, so here if you observe slanting rays are falling on the earth surface. So slanting rays, naturally it gives very less amount of temperature. So that is what here compared to equatorial region, so here it is getting more temperatures, more and more hotter because of the straight lines are passing on the surface of the earth. And second reason is tilt of the position. Tilt position of the earth is also one of the reason to receive these sun's rays straightly. Okay, the angle keeps increasing as we move towards the two poles. As a result, it is hotter in the areas which face the sun directly and less hot in the areas that receives the sun rays at an angle. That is what in the starting classes onwards I am telling you, the face of the earth, that means the tilt position is showing, is directly towards the sun rays. That part is getting more hotter, whereas the rays which are falling on the earth slantingly, that is receiving less temperatures. Understood, my dear? So the area which is receiving straight lines or straight rays, that part is having more temperature because of this tilt position of the earth. And where the position is receiving slanting rays, that is getting more or less temperatures, right? But this activity is repeating throughout the year. As a result of this tilt of the axis, the area which faces the sun directly, so it keeps changing throughout the year, it keeps shifting throughout the year. Okay, so here for your better understanding I am telling you, in March month if you observe, the sun shines directly over the equator. Okay, while in June month it shines directly over the Tropic of Cancer in the northern hemisphere. So you can also observe here in the top side, so the earth faces, okay, the earth faces in the March month of March, the sun shines directly over the equator. That is what from the month of March onwards we are getting more temperature. Okay, so summer season also will start from that March month. While in June, if you come to left side, the sun shines directly over the Tropic of Cancer in the northern hemisphere. So the tilt position of the earth is receiving here in the month of June. So the sun rays falls on the Tropic of Cancer. It lies on the northern hemisphere, right? Whereas in September, if you observe, as the earth travels further around the sun shines directly over the equator. So if you observe September month, the sun shines over the equator here. Whereas in December, if you observe, it shines over the Tropic of Capricorn in the southern hemisphere. When the earth comes this December month, immediately the southern part will face directly and receiving the rays from the sun. Understood, my dear? That is what these rays and sun shines over the Tropic of Capricorn. That is what in southern part is getting temperatures during December month. So this activity is not only one day or two days, it is continuing entire throughout the years and years. Okay, thus you can see that there is a belt within which the direct rays of the sun fall at some time of the year or the other. So it is continuing years together. That is what this temperature belts rotating years together. So this belt extending from the Tropic of Cancer to the Tropic of Capricorn, that is what it is called as tropical belt. So these temperatures are surrounding the temperatures are rotating from where to where it is falling and extending from the Tropic of Cancer, that means in the northern hemisphere, to Tropic of Capricorn in the southern hemisphere, right? So between these two tropical zones only the temperature belt is rotating. That is what this belt is called, tropical belt. Okay, this belt gets maximum heat energy from the sun. In your examination also they will ask some questions, which belt gets maximum heat energy from the sun. Okay, so what is your answer? Tropical belt. So they will give tropical belt, temperature belt, like that. But your answer is tropical belt, because the tilt of the earth, okay, and the rotation of the earth around the sun is changing months by months. That is what the face of the earth is receiving different temperatures in different months. So that is what different temperatures are forming. So these temperatures are affecting, and it is extending between the Tropic of Cancer and the Tropic of Capricorn. So that is what this belt is called as, tropical belt. So if we observe closely here, June 21st, the sun on the Tropic of Cancer, as we already discussed, in the June 21st, the sun rays falls on Tropic of Cancer, that is northern hemisphere. Okay. Whereas March 21st and September 23rd, if you observe, sun on the equator. So that region will receive summer season, more temperatures will be there in this. Okay. Whereas December 22nd, if you observe, the sun shines on the Tropic of Capricorn, that means southern hemisphere. Here very specially we have to discuss on March 21st and September 23rd. These 2 days, if you observe throughout the world, the day and night are equal in size. That means 12 hours daytime, 12 hours night time. So these are called as equinoxes. Okay. So entire the world, throughout the world, these 2 days will be equal daytime and equal night time. So it is called as equinoxes. Okay. So in examination also, they will ask some questions. What is the meaning of equinoxes? So your answer is, throughout the world, the day and night are equal in size. So this is called as equinoxes. When it will happen? March 21st and September 23rd. As we move northwards or southwards on the tropical belt, we reach a region where it gets warm in summer but also very cold in winter. This is called as temperate zone. So understood, my dear? Here, if you move after the tropical belt towards north direction or towards south direction, you will reach a region where it gets warm in summer and very cold in winter season. So this type of zone is called as temperate zone. Very specially in winter season, if you observe northern portions of this region, will get snow falling, heavy snow falling will be there in winter seasons. If you move further north or south of the temperate belt, you will reach the polar region. Understood, my dear? That means, so after temperate belt, you will reach polar regions. This region is very peculiar in seasons. That means the seasons in this region are very peculiar. Peculiar means very different. Okay, here this region is away from the sun during winter months and does not get any sunshine in the day, because here the sun shines slanting rays. So okay, this region is receiving very slanting rays, that is what here that much of temperatures will not form, and during the winter season 6 months they won't get sunshine. Okay, so that is what here, a place which has 6 months of day and 6 months of night, even during the daytime also it gets very slanting rays of the sun. So here the polar regions is very different, it's very peculiar. That means very different types of climates will happen during this northern pole or southern pole. Okay, so north pole, south pole regions are very peculiar. So here 6 months winter season will be there and 6 months summer season will be there. And also here very specially what they are telling, here a place, that means this north pole or south pole, has 6 months of day and 6 months of night. Okay, even during the daytime it gets very slanting rays of the sun, very less temperatures are forming. That is what, the sun does not rise high in the sky but only stays just above the sunrise point. Okay, so here that is what, it is not receiving, the sunshine is producing only slanting rays. That is what, it is not receiving high temperatures. Because of this reason only, in summer season also cool temperatures will be there. Okay, so here very specially, here one important point is there. For 6 months it is freezing cold, so cold that an entire ocean, one ocean is there, that is called Arctic Ocean, remains frozen throughout the year. So that this reason, particular this reason, that means sunshine, sun is not shining, it give not shining on the north pole or south pole, and it is receiving very less temperatures. So for this reason, so this region, the Arctic Ocean, remains frozen. That means completely in freezed state throughout the year. Examination point of it is very, very important. Which ocean remains frozen throughout the year? Your answer is Arctic Ocean. So here, so cold that the soil becomes frozen like a hard rock and roots of trees cannot penetrate them. So during this time, the trees cannot penetrate, means expand its roots. That is what trees cannot live during this frozen state. So trees just can't grow in this region. When the sun appears for 6 months, the snow melts, part of sea also melts. Small plants like moss, lichen and some flowering plants will grow. So during summer season only, that also receives very light temperatures, less temperatures. Because of this less temperature, the snow melts into water. All plants like moss, lichen and some flowering plants will grow here. Okay, these are fungal plants. So that only will grow during the summer months, right? So in your textbook also you can see how northern lights visible in northern polar region occur during the seasons when the sun does not rise above the horizon. Okay, so likewise, it's very peculiar temperatures or peculiar seasons will be there in the northern south poles. So my dear children, I hope you understood very clearly. So this is entire our third lesson. So I request you, all of you, finish your class works, bit part and project work also. Very soon we'll have exams also. I'll conduct one or two exams, and all of you get ready for the FAT exams. Maybe 8th onwards we'll start FAT examinations. So all of you prepare well. One side your preparation will continue, other side class also you have to listen, okay, and finish your pending works, class work and bit part as well as project work. Okay, until then, take care. Bye bye.